Hello everyone and welcome to today's video. In this video we are going to talk evolutions, and I know a lot of things have already been said about this Pokemon set over the last couple of months, but I still have the feeling that we have to talk a little bit more about it, because you see the price of an evolutions booster box just keeps on climbing and climbing and climbing, and a lot of people ask themselves the question if this can still continue or not, because the price of an evolutions booster box on today in Belgium, and I see it in more European countries, goes already up to 1000 euro, between 800 than 1000 euro are the most common sales at this particular moment, which is insane. I still can remember 1 year and a half I was sitting on the couch taking my tablet with me looking at secondhand websites in Belgium, and I found out that people were actually struggling selling them evolutions booster box for prices around 100 euro, sometimes 120 euro. So it's enormously that in only 1 to 1.5 years, the price of this booster box surges to 1000 euro. That means that if you're going to check the price for one booster pack, one evolutions booster box contains 36 packs, of course. Given the fact that it goes for 1000 euro, it's around 27 euro for one booster pack. That's also the price that you can see people actually pay. 27 euro is more rare. I see booster boxes go in an art set, so you have four arts from evolutions. You can already see them a little bit in front of you, but I also have just normal packs laying here. The first one is you have the Raichu one. The second one is the Blastoise art. Then you also, of course, have my big fella, Venusaur, which is my favorite one from all four. But hey, it's Venusaur. And then you have, of course, the big fella itself, Charizard. So those are the four arts that you have in Evolutions. You can also see them in the blister variant before you. This art set at this particular moment goes around 75 to 80 euros. If you see people selling them loose here in Belgium, I see them on Facebook groups. I also see them on secondhand websites offering them for 75 to 80 euro, and they actually sell. Which brings me back to the point that it's a little bit crazy knowing that you can sell these packs at this moment for such high price. And I will give you a couple of reasons why. The first reason is that up until today, you can still find evolutions packs and several products. We opened on this channel a lot of Galarian Sirfetch'd V boxes, and in every of those boxes you have one evolutions pack. You also still find them in Pokeballs. You had several new collection sets in the United States and Canada. They didn't came to Europe, but not such a long time ago. I believe they are called the Kanto Power Collection, I believe. I'm not quite sure about that. If I'm wrong, please correct me in the comments. But anyway, new collection boxes were actually released, which contained a hell of a lot of evolutions packs. So that brings me back to the first point, and that's that evolutions is one of the most printed sets from the last years, or maybe even from the entire Pokemon hobby ever. And I know they printed it so much because this set is gigantically popular and probably will always stay very popular. You have the variants from the original base set in it. You have a lot of very nice extra cards in that set. So I can understand why it's actually so popular, but still, the set has been printed so much, even if you have a gigantic popularity, the question will always be, will that popularity stay on the current level? Will it actually go higher, or will it drop back a little bit? Are also new people that are coming into this hobby interested in buying evolutions? Probably yes, because for a lot of collectors, the original base set is becoming maybe a little bit more too expensive. And I'm just talking about the cards. I'm not talking about the full booster boxes and sealed, which are extremely expensive and probably too expensive for most of collectors, including myself, by the way. So I can understand why new collectors look at evolutions instead of looking back at the original base set. But on the other hand, it's not base set. Every collector at this point, from my generation, maybe even a generation after and before me, will probably want to have also the original Pokemon sets. And that's include not only base set, also jungle, also fossil, also Team Rocket, whatever. But for sure that original base set. And we are talking about base set becoming too much expensive. But if you see prices for a booster box from Evolutions now go up to 1000 euro, in my opinion, it's only a matter of time before also this set will become too expensive for people to actually collect. It's also not only the sealed booster box that's getting more expensive, you also see the prices of several cards raise, like the Charizard normal card and the reverse holographic. They also continue to rise in price. I have to say, they continue in rise to prices. Maybe not entirely accurate, it's maybe not entirely true. You can see that they stabilized a little bit, which is also strange because the sealed booster box keeps on rising and rising and rising, and the cards don't show that actual the same rise in price. So that brings me also a little bit to the fact that if the booster box is at this moment not a little bit overvalued, and if you ask my honest opinion about it, I think yes it is. I don't see the price of 1,000 euro keep on the same level as it is today. That being said, I have to be honest, I already said that when the price of the booster box went to 600, 700, 750 euro, and now it's up to 1,000 euro. I have to say the price raise doesn't make any sense to me. I thought that it was a normal behavior after the popularity that Logan Paul brought to the hobby and to the Charizard card again, for sure, of course. And it would settle down and it would drop back a little bit. It didn't do that. And the opposite, as of today, you can see that all the prices, not only from the booster boxes, but also the booster packs and the blisters actually further rose. That brings me to my next point of this video, and I'm going to take away these booster packs because I want to show you another product. What I want to show you is the Elite Trainer box, and I will show you the most popular one. I actually also still have the Blastoise one, but I have to be honest, it is in storage. I only have one of the Charizard booster packs here, Elite Trainer boxes here, so that's the one that I will be showing you. It's this box. And the most important thing that I want to talk to you about in this video is the prices that are being asked for Elite Trainer boxes. Because if we are going to do that, we see that the price from a booster box at this moment is 1,000 euro. The price of an Elite Trainer box, I saw the two Elite Trainer boxes in sealed condition, sealed very good condition, nothing to worry about, go for 325 euro for both of the ETBs. And I have to be honest, if you are going to split that amount in half, it's 162.50 euro for one Elite Trainer box. Besides the additional content that you have into this ETB, you have 8 Evolutions packs in it. If you take a look at the price from the Evolutions packs, like I told you before, at this moment an art set goes for 80 euro. The price of the ETB, if you take that 162.50 euro and you know that there are 8 booster packs in it, the price for one booster pack into this ETB is 20.31 euro. So if we are going to compare that with the prices that our normal loose Evolutions packs are going, yes, it makes actually sense, because it is 20 euro for one pack, it actually makes sense. But it doesn't make sense that a booster box, which has been printed so many times, which is maybe still even in print at this moment, however, I know the rumors, so we are not entirely sure about it, I still leave it in the middle, is it still in print or not? But that being put aside, it has been printed so much. If we check the booster box and we take the price of 1,000 euro, we know that there are 36 booster packs in it, then the price for one booster pack goes to 27 euro for one. I'm staying quiet a little bit because you can understand that the price of a booster pack into a booster box is 7 euro more expensive than if you buy them loose as an art set or if you would buy an ETB. Why that doesn't make any sense to me is because from the ETB, there are two reasons. The first reason is, on the ETBs you have Charizard and you have Blastoise. Two from the three original starting Pokémon that are extremely popular. But there is a second point. You have 8 booster packs in it, but in fact that doesn't even make the most out of this, because An ETB is not printed like a booster box. Even at this moment, when you see that ETBs, as Hidden Fates, as Champions Path, even when you see at this moment that those ETBs are getting reprinted, they will never have the amount that a booster box would have. I know there are no booster boxes for Champions Path and Hidden Fates. I know that. That's, I think, also the main reason why they actually reprinted those ETBs, because they want to offer people the possibility to buy 10 packs for a decent amount of price. You also have the extra promo card with it. I highly doubt if it would be a set with booster boxes if they would actually reprint the ETB. Don't take me on those words, because it is still possible that we will see a reprint of Vivid Voltage and they will actually reprint the ETB. Still, I'm not quite sure about it and I don't think it's going to happen, but you never know. For as far as we know, also the ETBs from Evolutions have not been reprinted. Not the Charizard, not the Blastoise ETB. That means that there is way less supply from the ETBs than there is supply from the booster box. And still, that booster box is up to 1,000 euro. And up until today, you can still buy an Elite Trainer box from Evolutions for 160 euros. 160, 162, whatever, around that price. That really doesn't make any sense to me. If Evolutions, and I mean if Evolutions is still going to increase in price and a booster box will still continue to show an extra premium, the same will go for the packs, the same will go for the blisters that you see in front of you, it is not possible that the ETBs will stay at the current price level. That doesn't make any sense. They are more rare than the booster boxes. I know an Elite Trainer box is a little bit less desirable maybe than a booster box, but still, the supply is less. There has been way less printed of these ETBs, and they are featuring two of the original starting Pokemons, which are Charizard and Blastoise. And then we are not even going to talk about the additional content that you have into an ETB, because besides those 8 booster packs, you also have very nice sleeves. Okay, you have the energy cards, which is maybe, okay, I understand, energy cards. We all hate them, but hey, still, they are in it. You have the damage counters. You have a competition legal coin flip die. You have condition markers in it. You have, of course, the collector box itself. So you have a lot of actual more products, more rare items into an ETB than you have into a booster box. And still, the price of such Evolutions ETBs are only going around 160 euro. Does that mean that the price automatically will increase over time and in the short future? No, it doesn't mean that, because as I said before into this video, we are at a moment that for me, the price of a booster box from Evolutions is getting too high. I know how popular the set is, but you have to keep in mind that it has been printed so much. There is a lot of supply. Every person at this moment, the day of today, that wants to buy an Evolutions booster box can go to any Facebook group, can go to any secondhand website, can put an advertisement, and he will have a lot of offers to buy a booster box. That means, as long as you have constant supply, you have constant offerings to buy a booster box, it is not rare. And at the end of the day, we all know for sure, if you have a hobby as Pokemon, we all know that rarity over time is always necessary if you want to sell an item at a high premium price. And for me, Evolutions does not do that. Even it's extremely popular, a lot of people like it. I also like it. I enjoy my Evolutions Master set to the fullest. I really think it's a very good set, even though it's not printed in the best quality. I still enjoy Evolutions, but for me, the prices at this particular moment for this set doesn't make any sense. What I want to give as an extra piece of advice, if the prices of Evolutions at this moment stay the same or they are going to increase even more over the next coming months, keep a good look at the new collection boxes that are being released, because as I mentioned before, the supply of Evolutions is very big. Believe me that also Pokemon still has a very big supply of Evolutions. It is perfectly possible that in more collector's boxes to come and more collector's boxes that are on the way, you will still be able to find Evolutions packs. The same maybe even goes for the Pokeball tins that you can find in and several shops, and that will be actually released again over the next coming months. Also in those Pokeballs, not in all Pokeballs, ladies and gentlemen, be very careful, they are not in all Pokeballs, but in some Pokeballs you can also still find evolutions packs, even though probably they will not be in the best condition. So okay, that was what I wanted to talk to you about today. Please don't understand me wrong, Evolutions is a fantastic set. I really enjoy the set, I really enjoyed collecting it. I enjoy my Master set, I will not take part of it very soon. I even think the art on the blisters and the booster packs, if you see them, they are really great. I really enjoy having the ETBs in my collection. So don't get me wrong, I don't want to bash Evolutions. I just think that the price that we see up until today, especially from the booster box, is at this moment, it's too high. I don't think it's going to hold. I would also not suggest people to actually buy a booster box of Evolutions at this price. Don't get me wrong, ladies and gentlemen, always do your own research. I only give you my opinion. I'm not a financial advisor. Everything that I say into all of my videos is just my personal opinion. I can only tell you what I'm doing, what I think about a certain price. If you have a different idea, you're always welcome to leave it in the comments. I like discussions about the hobby, and I like discussions about, is an item being good priced or not, priced or not? Will it actually continue still in the future or not? So you don't have to agree with me, for sure not. As I said, I only give you my opinion. At this moment, I would not invest in another Evolutions booster box. If you still don't have it in your collection and you are a collector of sealed product and you actually would want to add a booster box to your collection, you can do two things. Or you wait a little bit and you see if the price actually has some kind of return, which, as I mentioned before, I think it actually will have. If you don't want to take a chance that the booster box will even still raise more in price, of course you are always able to at this moment buy it. If it actually drops, you would still have a good piece in your collection. Yeah, that being said, I don't see it go back at the price that it was 1 year and a half before. I don't see the Evolutions booster box again return to a price point of 100 to 125 euro. I also don't see that actually happening. But as I mentioned, at this moment, I think that the price of an Evolutions booster box is a little bit overrated, for sure, if you compare it with the low price that you can still obtain an Evolutions Elite Trainer box for, which could also be, of course, an alternative if you don't want to spend 1000 euro on a booster box from Evolutions, but you do want to actually buy Evolutions product. You can also look at the Evolutions ETBs. They are also pretty much available. You can find them pretty easy, and as I mentioned, for a price of 325 to 350 euro, it is actually possible to buy an Evolutions ETB. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like. If you want to see more content from me, please subscribe to my channel, and I would love to see you again in my next video, which will be actually coming up very soon. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.